Good morning, LED boys and girls. How are you? I hope all of you had a wonderful week, knowing that God is always hearing and listening to us, even in difficult times. So today, I want to invite you to worship our God together with these VBS songs.
Jesus is the Son of God.
VBS is happening next week. It starts on Thursday night and it ends on Saturday afternoon. Are you excited? All the teachers have been preparing diligently for you to have many fun activities, and also there will be many gifts prepared for all of you. Please pray that we can have a safe and fun time together.
Thank you for this wonderful day. Please let us listen to Pastor Han and let us have a great day. And just now I pray, Amen.
Awesome, guys. Today's Bible passage is on the book of Daniel, chapter 6, verse 10. Daniel, chapter 6, verse 10. Let's read it together. Now when Daniel learned that the decree had been published, he went home to his upstairs room where the windows opened for Jerusalem. Three times a day he got down on his knees and prayed, giving thanks to his God, just as he had done before. Now, we've already heard two stories that took place when God's people were exiled to Babylon because of their disobedience, right? First, we heard that God saved Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego from the king and the fiery furnace. And last week, we learned about Nebuchadnezzar's dream and how God humbled King Nebuchadnezzar to show that he is in control, right? And even though God's people were in a foreign country like Babylon, with a king that didn't worship the one true God, it's clear that he was still with them. In each story, we've seen that God displays his power. And today, let's find out what happened next with our Daniel.
King Darius was the new leader in Babylon. Babylon was a large kingdom. So the king picked men to be leaders over small parts of Babylon. The king picked Daniel to be one of the leaders. Daniel was very good at his job. So Darius decided to put Daniel in charge of all of Babylon. When the other leaders heard about this, they were jealous. They watched Daniel and waited for him to do something wrong so they could get him in trouble. But Daniel did what was right. The leaders knew Daniel obeyed God, so they made a plan to get Daniel in trouble for praying. They said to King Darius, "King, all of your leaders think it would be a good idea to pass a law. For the next 30 days, no one may pray to any god or man except to you. Anyone who disobeys the law will be thrown into the lion's den." King Darius agreed to pass the law. Daniel knew the law meant he was not allowed to pray to God. Still, Daniel went into his house and prayed to God three times a day, just like he had always done. The jealous leaders saw Daniel praying, and they told the king that Daniel had broken the law. King Darius was upset. He didn't want to punish Daniel. The king thought all day about how he could save Daniel from the lions. "The law can't be changed," the men reminded King Darius. So King Darius ordered Daniel to be thrown into the lion's den. "May the God you serve save you," he said. The king went to his palace for the night. He did not eat and he could not sleep. He thought about Daniel with the lions. As soon as the sun came up the next morning, the king hurried to the lion's den. He cried out, "Daniel, has your God rescued you from the lions?" Daniel shouted back, "God sent his angel to shut the lion's mouth. I am safe." The king was so happy. He ordered for Daniel to be taken out of the lion's den Daniel wasn't hurt because he had trusted in God. King Darius made a new law. Everyone must respect God. King Darius wrote, "He is the living God. He has rescued Daniel from the power of the lion." God showed his power to rescue Daniel from the lions, but Daniel was just a small part of a much bigger story. God ultimately rescued us from a much bigger problem, sin and death, through his son, Jesus.
Wow, I know you guys are all familiar with this story, right? Daniel was an honest and he worked hard in his role with the kingdom, within the kingdom. In fact, Daniel was so good in his job that King Darius wanted to put him in charge of the entire kingdom of Babylon. The other supervisors and governors, of course, they got jealous of Daniel. So they made an evil plan to harm Daniel. They tricked King Darius to pass a law that no one could pray to anyone but him, the king, for 30 days. Did Daniel stop praying to God? No, we saw in today's passage that Daniel kept praying. When he returned to his house to pray, Daniel wasn't trying to be like disobedient against the king. But Daniel knew that God was greater than any earthly king, even King Darius from Babylon. And Daniel wanted to obey God more than King Darius, and Daniel was willing to even risk his life by being thrown in the lion's den. He was that faithful to God. It might sound a little bit surprising that Daniel got caught in the end and thrown into the lion's den in the end. But we have to know that sometimes believing in God does not mean that we will always live good things in our lives. There will be times when we will go through hard times too. But the most important thing is to know and believe that God is always together with us, even in hard times. Amen? And especially in today's story, because Daniel went into the lion's den, God received glory. How? Well, God shut the mouths of the lions to save Daniel. And God showed King Darius that he is the living God who rules forever. Sometimes it may feel like that God isn't watching or listening to us. Maybe you have prayed for something and it seems like God didn't answered your prayer, or he doesn't even hear you. But one thing we learned that from today's story is that God is always listening. He's watching out for all of us, and he uses even our scary situations to show his power. Remember, we pray because we trust God and we know that he hears us. And God always answers our prayers, even when he gives an answer that we do not want. Whenever God does something different than the way we want it, it's because God knows what's the best for us. He knows better than us. So that's why we can be always thankful to God. Well, we saw that God saved Daniel today from the danger of the lion's den. But God also saved us, and He showed His power to rescue us from an evil, even bigger problem, the problem of sin. Yes, God saved us from this biggest problem of our lives, which is sin and death, by sending us His one and only begotten Son, Jesus Christ. And through Jesus, we can be sure that we are saved from our sins and death. We just have to believe in it. Isn't that amazing? I am so thankful for Jesus and God. So now, let's pray and give thanks to God. Let's pray. God, You are amazing. We learned from today's story that You saved Daniel from the lion's den, and You also saved us from our sins. Through Jesus Christ, we have now eternal life in You. Help us to believe in this truth and to love You and to obey You more day by day, because You set an example for us through the life of Jesus Christ. We love You and we give thanks in Jesus' name. Amen. Good, everyone. Thank you so much. And let's do our activity pages together to learn more about today's story and about God. Thank you so much and see you on Thursday. BBS is coming. See you.